somewhere I was very sure that I had spent a lot of time preparing myself, you know, working on my craft and skill. I know my job. I just need that one role. It will put me back again.
So, Manoj, the other thing we wanted to ask you was that, you know, many startups have great ideas, but the ones that do really well are the ones that are creating an institution. They have great values. They have a moral integrity. So, you know, our vision is, of course, to serve the country and be a nation-building brand. But we also want to make sure that 20 years from now, when people look back at Rupeek, they think this is the new Tata. This is the new Hindustan Unilever of India. How do you, in your ups and downs, especially when you've had the downs in your life and career, how do you maintain your integrity to your craft, to who you are as a human being, your values? Because there would be temptations, right, to compromise.
Right.
Because the same thing holds true for a company like ours as well, as we create an institution.
I've never taken it as a low time. You know, I've taken it as a time to reinvent myself, to rework on my craft, reevaluate myself. And my discipline in my low time was, you know, far more higher than my high time. This is something that I have decided, that I'll get up in the morning. I'll be far more disciplined about my yoga, my dhyan, my reading, my practice. And I will take a bath, do puja, and wear a new clothes as if I'm ready to get out and go do my work. So I used to wear nice clothes, use perfume, and then again sit down at home and do other things. So you have to be ready. You can't be, you know, thinking that since I don't have work, so I don't have choices, I'm not getting the kind of work that I want to do, I am going to be in my comfortable clothes and I'm going to sit down. No, day has to start on a high. It's a working time. So if I'm wearing nice clothes, you know, putting on perfume, and even if I'm sitting down and reading a book or reading a script, reading something and watching something, I'm doing my job. You know, the mindset is I am on the job. So what? The offer is not coming from outside. But I have loads of things to do on my own. So that was something, that mindset and that new idea about the discipline, it actually you know, made me go through it so well, with so much positivity and optimism. I used to go back to my village and sit with the, you know, all those people and, you know, really experience the life all over again, go meet my school friends in my small town, my school, go to some interiors of Maharashtra and explore the area. So I was not sitting and doing nothing and waiting for the chances. If at all I had to do a work, which I thought that, you know, I shouldn't do it, but I had to do it for my own need, I kept on telling myself that I'm doing it for my needs, so that I can have the chances, I can survive till the time I get choices. So you have to remind, even if you're making a compromise, you have to tell yourself, that you are doing it so that you can do some great work in future. Don't try to justify that. This was very clear that in my mind, I'm not going to justify the work that I'm doing. I'm going to remember that I'm the reason why I've done this work, you know. So these were the things, these were the elements which kind of put me back again, you know, in the thick of the things. Preparing yourself for the opportunity is very, very essential. You know, I keep telling my students when I conduct workshops, you know, I said, you know, you guys are sitting and, you know, wasting your time thinking that when you'll get an opportunity, you will do it. And I am saying, you prepare yourself for any kind of an opportunity so that you leave a mark, so that that opportunity is not wasted. So that even if you're getting two scenes, your presence is felt. Your presence is registered. So prepare yourself for the time, for that time, when you get that opportunity, even if it is small. So, and I knew, Shalabh, I knew, when even if it was a low time in between for me, somewhere I was very sure that I have spent a lot of time preparing myself, you know, working on my craft and skill. I know my job. I just need that one role. It will put me back again. I was very sure of that. I was sure of it, not because I was overconfident. I was sure of my own discipline and preparedness that I was doing every day.
We felt that there were three stories that you have done that are the best in your career. And we also told you're very decisive, so you will choose one of them. So I'm going to give you three options, and I want you to, I'd love for you to know which one of them. One is Satya.
Okay.
Second is Rupik. Third is Gangs of Wasseypur.
Well, there are no.
don't want you put in a spot. Just thought we'd end on a lighter note.
I always say that, you know, without Satya, there wouldn't have been a career for me. So definitely, you know, you choose what has really catapulted you into people's mind. Why I say Rupik? Because I'm a middle class person here. So when I see and whatever I was talking to you guys, this came out of experience and out of heart. You know, I was not talking because I had to talk, because it all came from the experience, and I relate to Rupik's vision. I relate to it because I know what hard cash means to a family who is in dire need, and you know, everything starts from there. And that is why the whole journey which started with you makes it so special for me. So when you know it, when you relate to the vision and to the whole idea, the journey becomes very special. It's like sitting next to a passenger, you know, and you don't know each other. And after an hour, you both are eating out of the same tiffin, you know. So is that kind of a journey?
Great. Thank you, Manoj, for your partnership. And just to end from my side, and Sumit might have a few things to say, I think there are two people I admire right now at this point in time. One is Neeraj Chopra, and second is Manoj Bajpayee, because I think you're both sons of the soil, and you love your craft, and everything else happens. Yes. Thank you for being who you are. I think a great actor. I think this has been a lesson in life today. And thank you for your partnership. I think we are grateful.
Thank you very much. I we all started on such a great note. And I just pray to God that it all goes on a full speed from here.
Thank you so much. And, you know, success from people, and, you know, you being successful more and more gives inspiration to millions of people who want to follow footsteps just like you did. It really reaffirms your belief in the tough times that, you know, this formula which you talked about, staying true to yourself and just giving the day in day out hard work, it will get you to the success. So thank you for being a role model there, and really, really appreciate you partnering with us.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Take care.
Thank you, Avinash. Thank you, Shalabh.
Bye, Manoj.
Bye.